Hello, I'm Tucker Wittig, product specialist for the baler product lines at Kuhn North America. Welcome to our Expert Insights video series, where we aim to provide information that could increase efficiency on your farm. Today, I would like to talk about the advantages of producing pre-sized forage, in particular, the returns to operating a baler which uses a rotor knife system to pre-cut your forage. There are many benefits to using a baler with a cutting rotor, or in the case of Kuhn balers, an opti-cut rotor. Pre-sizing crop material allows you to add value to your operation at multiple parts of the bale's life cycle, from the field until that bale is fed to your livestock. For this video, I will break down the benefits of pre-cut bales into four categories: transportation and packaging savings, improved silage feed value, increased feeding efficiency, and savings while processing bales. When it comes to transportation and packaging, your costs are directly connected to the density of your bale. Denser bales use less net wrap, less plastic film when wrapping, and less fuel to transport the same amount of feed. Packing more tonnage into each bale allows you to reduce the overall number of bales you handle, saving you time and money. Opti-cut balers allow you to reach higher bale densities by sizing the crop into smaller pieces, which fit together tightly. Independent studies have shown a 10% increase in bale density with pre-cut bales compared to a non-cut crop. Transportation savings with denser bales is seen across the bale supply chain. The farmer produces fewer bales overall, has fewer bales to move off the field, and fewer bales to move to the final feeding place. Producers who sell hay and alfalfa can see a large transportation savings when getting that feed to the point of sale. Net wrap, twine, and plastic film wrap are very costly inputs for any farm producing bales. A 10% decrease in net twine and film add up to large savings over the life of your opti-cut baler. In addition to transportation and packaging savings, improved bale density from opti-cut baler results in higher feed value for ensiled bales. Processing crop down to as little as 1.8 inches in length with an opti-cut baler creates a bale with less air per cubic foot. All operators who wrap hay know oxygen is the enemy of a good silage bale. When forage is ensiled, oxygen is stored between forage particles. Pre-cutting bales with an opti-cut baler allows for smaller sized forage particles to fit tightly together, trapping less air. This is similar to how a glass filled with large ice cubes leaves a lot of empty space, but a glass with crushed ice leaves very little space to add your beverage. Lowering the oxygen content in your wrap bales reduces the breakdown of carbohydrates, which result in poor feed, and instead convert those carbohydrates to lactic acid, which is responsible for high quality silage. Producing a high density silage bale results in better fermentation process, increasing feed value and return on your investment. Running a baler with an opti-cut cutting rotor benefits a farmer who is baling dry hay by reducing feed waste and improving feed intake when the bale is fed. When a steer reaches into a feeder and pulls out a mouthful of long-stemmed hay, only 4 or 5 inches of that hay is actually within the steer's mouth. The remaining hay, which hangs outside the steer's mouth, will fall to the ground and be wasted when the animal starts to chew. This can often be seen with a large buildup of feed on the outside of a bale ring feeder. Feeding forage of smaller lengths keeps the majority of the hay within the cattle's jaw and off the ground. Feeding hay of shorter lengths also allows your cattle to consume feed at a higher rate, resulting in a faster weight gain. Hay pre-cut with an opti-cut baler is small in size, requiring less chewing and less time for cattle to ingest that mouthful of feed and move on to the next. Independent research studies have shown feeding pre-sized hay results in higher rate gains on cattle. For an operation which uses a mixer to combine a ration and process hay, bales cut with an opti-cut intake system break apart easier, greatly reducing the time and horsepower required to mix the ration. To show the difference in mixing times when processing cut versus uncut bales, Kuhn performed a side-by-side demonstration with 2 5x6 foot bales, both processed in identical VT156 G2s. The two bales used were both made with a Kuhn VB560 round baler. However, one bale was made with the opti-cut model and the other was not. The mixer on the left-hand side is processing the bale which was made with an opti-cut rotor. This mixer is able to tear the bale apart in a smooth manner, fully separating the bale in only 1.5 minutes. The mixer on the right-hand side is processing a bale of full-length crop. The bale is much harder to break apart, shifting in the mixer, creating high and low horsepower loads on the tractor. It takes 4.5 minutes of mixing to break this bale apart, 3 times longer than the cut bale. In this demonstration, the VT156 G2 on the right continued to mix the uncut hay after it was fully broken apart in order to reduce the particle size down to similar lengths as the cut hay produced with the opti-cut baler. Producing a similar particle length with this mixer took on average of 12 minutes of total mixing time, 10.5 minutes longer for the same product. Based on average mixing times for our demonstration, it is roughly 8 times more expensive to break apart and size an uncut bale compared to an opti-cut bale when using a mixer. This is a huge potential savings for your operation. Whether you are selling bales, buying bales, or baling your own feed, operations of every size and structure can benefit from producing and feeding bales pre-cut with an opti-cut rotor. Thanks for watching this episode of Kuhn Expert Insights, and be sure to check us out on MyKuhn and social media.